So, I heard you want to be a 3D artist, but it require money for school, software and skills? Now let me find you an alternative. Welcome here, I'm Thomas, professional generalist artist, and this is the first video of this series where I will show you everything you need to know to get your first job in the VFX industry starting from zero. Even if it starts to change, Maya is still the industry standard right now, unfortunately. So let's focus on this software first, and then you will be able to apply your knowledge to other similar software like Blender, for example. First, just so you know, Maya have a free student version. If you are not a student, there is also an indie version at a reduced price to avoid the holy godly fee that learning this software cost. And as I think education should be free for everyone, this is the mantra of this channel, I will let you find ways to deal with the download of the software and keep your money for the thing that actually matter. Inside Maya, it looks like that. Let's have a look at the fundamental first. No need to remember everything, you will remember as you start actually working with it. Let's start with the viewport. It's where you can see your 3D scene. Here are the tools, the outliner, the attribute editor, the channel box, the shelves, the tool property. And this is the shelf modifier that changes everything depending on what type of work you are working on right now. Catch your breath, here we go with more essential information. To navigate in the viewport, Alt and left click allow you to rotate in the view. Alt right click allow you to zoom, and Alt middle click allow you to move. Yes, you will need a mouse, sorry trackpad user. In the shelf, you can create polygon. It's inside the poly modeling shelf and you have multiple shapes available, but let's just focus on the cube right now. In the channel box, it will be where you can see some information about the polygon, translation, rotation and scale. So you can change this value here, and a little tips will be to hold Ctrl and drag left click to be able to change the value more precisely than a simple drag left click. You can also change this value with tools that you can control directly in the 3D view. This is the translate tool, the rotate one and scale one. Yes, you can find them in the tool shelf, but let's learn the hotkey right away. It's the most handy one. W for translate, E for rotate and R for scale. Yes, it don't make sense, but let's still learn it. Now that you play with your first polygon, let's have a look at the outliner. Here you can find a list of what is present in your scene. We can also rename stuff. For that, double click on our cube and let's find a proper name. In a studio, every object will follow a specific naming convention. A really important thing now is to set your project. By default, you are working on the default Maya folder. And when you start to accumulate projects, this is a total mess. You have to create a new project folder every time you are working on a new project. For that, go to File, Project Windows. In the current project, click on New, give it a location and a name, and that's it. If you need it, you can definitely add folder inside the project. For example, me, I like to add a resources folder for my inspiration. Now, the last really important feature that will allow you to model anything is to be able to select what you want in Maya. Right now, if you do a left click on your cube, we are selecting the whole polygon. But if you click on this icon, we can select components instead of objects. In Maya, you have different type of components, vertices, edges, and faces. To select them, instead of clicking on the icon, I prefer holding right click and then select the component I want. You will see the more you will learn about Maya and the less you will go in the shelves and actually doing shortcut for it. So you may wonder, in which situation will it be useful to do that? Absolutely every one of them. It will be the basic to learn how to model and doing every model you want inside Maya. So yeah, click on the subscribe button because I will show that on the next video when we will learn about how to model everything. And in any cases, do not worry. With hard work and dedication, you will find success in your passion, regardless of natural talent or expensive degrees. So stay motivated.